Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome to the stage the one and only Sydnee Washington!
Hey, sexy-ass crowd, hello. I'm a comedian. I know I look like I might be a waitress or a waitress, or I do spoken word. I am definitely a comedian. I did something drastic lately. I cut my hair. You like it? You like? I don't know. I don't trust white people. Black people, what you like? You like? Do it look good? Okay, cool. I used to have really long hair. It used to be down in here. Okay, I'm lying. It used to be right here. Okay, I'm lying. I was wearing somebody else's hair, but whatever. So I took the weave off, and I had a bet. Someone bet me to shave my head, and I was like, nah, I'm not that confident in my face. You know what I mean? Like, I'm trying to get some shit for free. I just don't think I can do the Sinead O'Connor look. That's not... I'm trying to get some free shit in the bodega. You know what I mean? Like, you gotta have a bang or something so they could give you a free beef patty with cheese. That's what... Or maybe some Swedish fish or some boar's head. That's what I'm really trying to do. If you bald-headed, if you're a Make-A-Wish or a cancer patient, they're not going to give you anything for free. Have your money ready, cancer people. It's crazy. So they started shaving off the side of my head, and I started getting nervous because I was like, man, I don't think I'm going to get any compliments in the hood. I really don't, because this is kind of like the WNBA haircut. It kind of looks like I play basketball. Well, I be on the bench. That's what I look like, you know? So I walk out of the salon, and right away, a construction worker is on my jock. You know what I mean? Like, he's calling me out. I was like, you don't even have a hard hat on. You don't take your job seriously. I can't really fuck with you, Bob, without your fucking hard hat, you know? So I'm a professional black woman, and I play him out, you know? I'm like, Bob, I'm busy. I don't have time. I mean, I have a lot of time, but whatever. And this construction worker got so mad. He was like, all right, then fuck you then, Dyke. Wow, that's aggressive. Okay, Dyke on a Tuesday, like at 2 p.m., like that. Dyke is like Friday night after a couple Jägermeisters. Or Dyke is at a family reunion. Like that's when I hear Dyke. You don't hear it on the corner of 125th. It's just really weird. So he calls me a dyke, and I'm like, I gotta come back with something, you know? He's not just gonna call me a dyke and try to embarrass me in front of these people that I don't know. So I tell him, I say, wait till my man come here and fuck your ass up. That's what I say. I get on the phone, I'm like, hello, yeah, babe. Yeah, there's a construction worker trying to play me out. I need you to come here right now. Okay. Then I realize I don't have a man. And my girlfriend shows up. You know what I mean? Because I am a dyke. I am definitely a lesbian. But let me tell you, I was a lesbian before the haircut. You know what I mean? Like, I just finalized it. So now I'm full-blown lesbian, you know? Like, top-shelf lesbian. I've been doing it for 2 years. Thank you. It's a full-time job. I was just doing it on the weekends after a couple cocktails, but now I'm sober and I'm just like in vagina, like with both my eyes open. It's intense. I was like, wow, that's what it looked like? Woo! Woo! Cyclopedia didn't tell me it looked like that. That's crazy. I don't know. I've been doing it for 2 years. I live with my girlfriend. I moved to Bushwick. I left my washer and dryer. Like, this is pretty damn serious. I would never leave my washer and dryer for dick. I just wouldn't. It was a good washer and dryer. Like, it worked, you know? I don't have to move the knobs or anything. It just fucking works. 2 years. I feel like I have enough lesbian credits, but no, I don't. I'm still like a entry-level lesbian. Like, I look like I got the job, but I could get fired today. That's what kind. I'm always on probation with pussy. It's so frustrating, you know? You think that, like, because I live with her, you know, I tell her my feelings, we're very intense. You would think that would be enough to be a lesbian. No, you need, like, 3 references. There's somebody reviewing my file right now. They're like, you need some more time in this. Mm-mm. We don't believe you. Men don't believe me. Because I used to date men. I used to do that. But now I have standards. You know, that's how it works. I got some sense now. I can see. I can see clearly now. The sperm is gone. That's how I have standards. But men, they're so confident. They're like, you know, once the rest of your hair grows back, you'll be back. You will be back. I'll be with my girlfriend sometimes, holding her hand, doing, you know, real gay stuff. And guys whisper in my freaking ear. They're like, you'll be back. What do you see my dick? What? Is that Yin Yang Twins from 2001 whispering in my ear in this bodega? Are you see? Oh, y'all white people don't know who Yin Yang Twins are? Good. You should know because they haven't had a hit since 2001. It's good. Guys call me the LeBron James of lesbians. That's what they call me. They say that I'm just another team to get a couple rings. But in 7 years, I'll be back home. Nope, burn my jersey. Burn my jersey. This is my new home. I'm here to stay. I thought that because I'm a woman and she's a woman, you know, I know what she wants. We want the same thing. You know, I thought I knew how to please her. I was super confident. I just threw my whole arm in there. I was like, ah, take the whole arm. Take this elbow. Take this knee. She was like, no, no. She turned the lights on and she's like, no, that's not. What have you been watching? You know, it's like the L word. That's what I've been watching. Doing some research. But I love that she was so honest with me. I love that she turned the light on. She was like, no, bitch, that's not it. You can't do that with a dude. You can't tell a dude that his dick ain't shit. You can't tell him that. Because you know, you tell him that, and the next day he'll shoot up a Starbucks. Like, that's how he will shoot up a Starbucks, and it'll just so happen your day that you're like, I was going to get some pumpkin spice latte. Now you done shot up the whole Starbucks. It sucks. It's pretty serious for y'all. You know it's real. You're like, there's somebody in here that might shoot up a Starbucks, so. I've been with her for 2 years. It's dope. I'm very vain, though. Like, she lets me know that I always care about my looks. I think that I'm one of a kind. Does anybody feel like that? That there's nobody else that looks like you? Oh, just me with self-confidence. Okay. I don't think there's nobody that looks like me. Okay, I spent 2 hours on his face, 2 hours on his hair, and then I walk into a bar and somebody mistakes me for another black woman all the time. One time this guy was like, don't you work at Dallas BBQ's on 23rd Street? What? This is not a Sticky Wings face. I'm sorry. This is not a Texas Dallas-sized culada. Are you serious? Yeah, they do have good drinks, okay? But I don't have that drink face, okay? One time I was working at my bar, and this guy mistaken me for this chick named Black Magic. I don't know, that sounds racist. That doesn't sound good. I don't know if that's a new rapper on the street who, he's like, didn't I give you $500 on Monday? Don't you work at the strip club? What? You gonna call me Black Magic and then you think I'm a stripper? First of all, I'm a prestigious black woman, okay? Come to find out, prestigious is a stripper as well. I was like, how do I look like a stripper? I have a turtleneck on, okay? This is top of the line, H to the ism, okay? How dare you think I'm a stripper? He's like, oh my God, I'm sorry, my bad. You gotta go to the strip club. Tell him Greg sent you, okay? And I went, because I had a coupon. I went there to see who this Black Magic was. I was like, she better fucking look like me. She better have a big ass forehead. She better have these fucking cheeks. She better look good. Black Magic looks nothing like me. She's a white woman with a turtleneck. That's it. That's all she had. I was like, I gotta stop buying these H to the ism turtlenecks. They $5, but they fucking me up, man. I don't know. I'm very vain. I feel like women always have to freaking look good, don't you think? Clap if you feel like you always have to look good for no damn reason. I went into Equinox on a buddy pass because I don't want y'all to think I got money. I went in there and there was women wearing matching tops and bottoms just to sweat in. Just to sweat. Matching top and bottoms. Lululemon yoga pants for $100. Then I looked to the men, what are they working out in? Oh, swimming trunks. And free t-shirts that got spaghetti stains on them. Oh, you're just living too comfortable at this gym, Tom. We always gotta freaking look good. You know, even on our death, women have to look good. There's a woman right now getting Kim K contour in a casket. It's crazy. I went to 7 funerals because black people be dying, and the women were in the casket, and somebody went there and came back, and they were like, she looked good. That's not the response I want. I want to know that she looked dead. That's what, I don't want to be competing with no dead woman, all right? And then I go up there, and I'm like, damn, she do look good. Shit, who the hell did her makeup? She looked like she paying attention, you know what I mean? She looked like she's saying, mm-hmm, that's what I want. Because that's what I want in makeup, you know? I feel like makeup doesn't really do the things that I want it to do. Yeah, it gets me like free drinks and maybe a couple trips. Okay, I don't want any of those things. I'm very simple. I go into Sephora and they ask me, what look are you looking for? And I'm like, oh, you know, I just want a natural look but with a lot of makeup on, okay? I want to look like myself but better. They're like, no, no, no. You want to look like Naomi Campbell. That's who you want to look like. You want to look like Kerry Washington. You want to look like Kelly Rowland. You are like, who are all these people? Are these your cousins? Kelly Rowland. Y'all know who Kelly Rowland is? Clap. Okay, cool. Thank you. Because sometimes I'll be going to the shows and the white people are like, is that a relative? Kelly Rowland, Destiny's Child, 2nd Beyonce. That's, yes, yes. Kelly Rowland is the vice president of Beyonce. If Beyonce lost a leg right now, Kelly Rowland would be ready in a Tina Knowles original, ready to do Single Ladies, all right? She'd be off beat, but she'd be ready to do it, okay? She is the Joe Biden of fucking Beyonce. That's, and I had to find out who the vice president of the United States to do that joke, okay? I was like, I don't know no Joe. I know a Kelly, though. I feel like some crazy stuff going on, especially with me. I'm sober now. Anybody sober? Yay! Isn't it crazy you can hear now? Wow, everybody, conversation sucks. It's terrible. You know why I stopped drinking? I accidentally lost my job. That's what happened. You thought I went in there and like fucked some shit up. No, I just fell asleep. That's what happened, I fell asleep. Oh, that's not sad. There was a good nap. It was a great nap. I was well rested, and when I woke up, they were like, get your ass out of here. You got to go. You need to get on your own bed and go to sleep. I was like, you sure? This floor feels really great. I'm sober now because of my girlfriend, because women, they get you together. My girlfriend is awesome. She's very open. Anybody else open in here? Oh, y'all all just holding your feelings inside? My girlfriend does like some freaky stuff. Clap if you're freaking here. Miss, you giving me these vibes. You giving me this Ann Taylor, Ann Loft type vibes, but I feel like you got some freakiness inside you. What's the craziest thing you've ever done? Listen, we are in an intimate space. People are wearing clean socks. I mean, I went to a show and the guy was like, oh, I had gerbils in my ass. I was like, wow. Y'all Anglo-Saxons are wild. She don't have no rodents in the bed. We don't do that. She do some wild shit. She do. She kisses with both her eyes open. That is wild, right? That is like top shelf freak to me. The only reason why I knew she had both her eyes open because I had one eye open making sure she wasn't stealing shit, you know? You can't trust these Brooklyn girls. They wild. They take everything. Hey, I mean, I didn't have shit to steal in the first place. But I got to protect my nothing, you know? I asked her. I was like, Adrian, what the hell are you looking at? What are you looking at, Adrian? She's like, I just want to see your feelings. Okay, she didn't say it like that, but that's how it came out, you know? I was like, see my feelings? With both your eyes open? Does anybody do that in here? Clap if you do, just whistle. You? Man, that is gay. That is, sorry if I just outed you, but that is like certified gay. My girlfriend is like very militant black. Like she like white people, but she don't like working for them. She really don't. Oh no, y'all hard to work for. Just so you know, the Post-its, the emailing, when I'm right in your face. You emailing me while I'm in your face, telling me that I'm not on time. You could have just told me that I was not on time and I was still not gonna be on time, but. She always wants to talk about race, you know? And I just wanna chill. I really just wanna Netflix and chill. I just wanna watch a regular ass movie. What's a movie that doesn't have anything to do with race? What, like, call something out right now. Terrible movies, terrible. I want classics. No, those are all awful. Those are not on Netflix. E.T., that's my shit. That's my shit. That doesn't have anything to do with race. It's an alien. It's like a little white boy who got a walk-in closet. You know, it's just pretty simple. So I get emotional because as an adult, you see that like the little boy and his alien are like really friends. Like he's really protecting E.T. He's making sure like he doesn't get caught up. And I was like, yo, my friends would have gave me away for a Snickers bar like that. They would have not protected me at all. I really got caught up. Do you remember the part where E.T. is on a stretcher and he's all dry and like ashy and he dying? And I was like, little white boy, get him some shea butter, you know? That's what happened when a white person is your best friend. They got you all dry. I'm like, come on, get him some Carmex, something. So he over there like dying, like, and I'm bawling my eyes out. Also, my direct deposit didn't hit. So I was a couple of things that had me fucked up, but I started crying. As a 31-year-old, I started crying during E.T. And my girlfriend turned the fucking light on. It's something about her turning on. I know she got Con Ed and she paid one time. She just wanna make sure the electricity work and shit. She's like, we gonna turn the lights on again. She's like, you're fucking crying right now? You crying about fucking E.T.? When our brothers and sisters are dying out there right now? E.T. was on a bike with a hoodie with a white boy on it going to the moon. He would have been shot if he was a nigga. I was like, wow. She got a point though. She got a damn point. It's true, right? He had a red hoodie on top of that. I was like, ugh. He E.T. all gang and related and shit. So I was like, what I gotta do to fix this? What would you do, sir? He's white. He's like, I have nothing. I'm good answer. Good answer as a white dude. I was like, man, I gotta do something about this. So I get on Twitter, because that's how I do, you know? I was like, I gotta figure out something cute to write. I was like, hashtag ET don't matter. That's what I wrote. I got one retweet and I got ass that night. So it worked. One last thing, I feel like I'm glad that I'm 31 and I'm confident. That's hard to hear, right, as a woman? No, because I feel like women put themselves down all the time just to be relatable. But I was like, look at these cheeks, I can't. I'm trying to stop wearing makeup, I'm trying to stop. Not today though, because we on camera, okay. Gotta make sure I got that little contour. But I'm trying to get rid of makeup because it's just freaking ridiculous. I used to carry with me everywhere I went. One time I was hooking up with this dude and in the middle of it, I started crying. And without missing a beat, he was like, I know, it's so good. What? Yes. Yes, he did. These Harlem dudes, they got mad confidence. Right, mad confidence. He was like, yo, B, word to my mother. Word to my mother, I didn't even put it all in yet, so. I was like, no, Jared, I just lost my bang-up bag. That's what I lost. How I'm gonna leave this place with the face I came in with? How I'm gonna do that? I came in looking like Kelly Rowland and left looking like Wesley Snipes. It was crazy. It was definitely real. It was so real. But now I'm just me now. Aren't you happy with that? You can get this whole face for $345 at Sephora, okay? Thank you. Okay, you guys have been great. Thanks so much. I'm Sydnee Washington.
Sydnee Washington, ladies and gentlemen. You just killed it right in front of me. That was extraordinary.
Oh, my God, they spelled my name right. That's awesome.
They work very hard here. That's something they're good at WNYC. Oh, y'all missed it. She just crushed it.
Hey, guys.
That was a terrific set. I know that you have many of the members of Vicky Cristina Barcelona doing red wine spit takes in the hallway back there. That was beautiful. Tell me, where can we find you next?
Because I have a monthly show called The Warm Up at Karma Lounge. It's free.
Where is Karma Lounge?
Yeah, it's on 3rd and 1st Avenue.
I live on St. Martin first.
It's not a girl. It's not. It's a bar.
Okay. Oh, I know her.
You should come. It's free. The next show is November 12th.
All right.
Yeah. Whoa! Yeah. Drink tickets for you.
And tell me about your podcast.
It's called The Unofficial Expert.
And what happens on that show?
Basically, we interview people who think they're experts in things that we don't give a damn about. Like a wingman, or like a drug expert, or like a nanny, or like a hood expert, or like a white guy expert, or bro. It's so many experts that nobody gives a damn about. But we quiz them and make sure that they are like official or unofficially experts for us. And it's fun. And it's only an hour.
Tell me the name again.
The Unofficial Expert.
The Unofficial Expert. Yes. We can find it on iTunes
and
all the usual places.
Yes, you can. iTunes. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, another round of applause for this beautiful
Thank
and
you.
Hilarious woman, Sydnee Washington.